Yo, how's it going? It's me again at 3 a.m. at Friday night playing this game again. You know what it is. It's Horace. Alright, I gotta figure out what to do right now. I know I got a map with some skulls on it, but I don't know like what that means. That's what that means. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. God, what's up with this sad song, though?
The block was very shiny. It looked like it might be able to reflect the laser beams.
I don't know what I'm turning here. Oh, that. It seems complicated. Gosh, Michael. I might have already messed this up. Oh shit. Why do I do this to myself? Bush. box again.
After a while, I thought maybe it was a good idea to get the shiny block.
got a boom. What the? First boss is supposed to be here. Probably right up top. I don't get it. I don't remember any of this stuff, the mechanics. So that's why I'm not getting hit by everything. What the hell is up with these spiders? Oh god. Jeez. thumbs up or that one. Oh my god. No, it's not worth it. You know, what's the password? Joshua. I don't know why I know this. What to do? I don't know how to get to the other side though. I'm dead. Seen that coming a mile away. What? Okay.
This door looked big and important. I would need another security pass to open it. This door looked big and important. I would need another security pass to open it.
No, don't see myself going there. I need like something here. I don't know what. Like a new skill or something. Oh, jeez. Can't go to the right. I guess heading to the left door, but I can't go to the left either. I have to go left bottom or something, maybe. I guess I can take the elevator. Did I go right already? I think I did. I'm gonna double check. I did, yeah. Library map room. There was a picture that somebody posted that had the entire map for this game. Let's see if I can find it. Hey, these are my screenshots. Yeah, I can't find it. Oh well, that's all right. Okay, if I go right on this room, yeah, I'm gonna go left. Leaves like right on top is the boss, but I don't think I can get there. I'm gonna try it anyways. Oh my god. I shouldn't have gotten hit there. Yeah, I'm not gonna go inside here right now. Priority is the left room here, I think. No. Not sure why I need this, but need this for something. Oh, for this. Jeez.
Some things were worthless junk, but this could be sold for a decent price.
No. No. Make mistake? Came from here, right? Yeah. This is the boss room. This is a hard boss, dude. Stop like throwing the books at him. Oh my god. Oh god. Oh my god. I didn't realize. Jeez. I don't get it. Oh my god. Jeez Louise. I already lost my lucky charm. Wait, it's not here? Oh. He's flying books, man.
As if from nowhere, Heather appeared. I was shocked. The house was a dangerous place for a well-trained robot, let alone a young lady. Why are you so surprised? She asked. I know this place at least as well as you. I was able to salvage some circuitry from the other robot, and Heather was more than happy to help fit it. Heather showed me her robot manual and explained how I would use this new power-up. It was designed for demolition units and seemed that it reinforced my shoulders, allowing me to barge through old or crumbling walls. The controls relied on a press of either of the shoulder buttons to activate the dash and subsequent wall smash. The machinery looked like it would explode in 10 minutes. I had to get it back to the hallway. I just hoped someone knew what to do with it.
I don't know what to do with this. I think I have to bring it all the way down. I went this way. Then down left.
Upon my return, The old lady and the blind man fitted the circuitry. I was worried about Mr. Deck as he seemed depressed about being chained up. But when I tried to talk to him, he just looked angry and went back to his lovely music. So I made my way up to the roof to help everyone fit the satellite dish, and bring us one step closer to broadcasting the nice virus. With some brilliant timing, as we all climbed down from the roof, the professor appeared. I think this was the youngest I had ever seen him. Mr. Preston looked most shocked. When we last saw you, you were... But the professor cut him off, explaining, "Stop, I can't risk my mission by knowing too much about my personal future." Mr. Deck was so pleased to see him, saying, "Thank God you're back. It's terrible here with these savages." When we explained what we were trying to do, the professor seemed pleased and offered to help. Somehow his box opened some kind of portal and he urged me to step through. I was slightly apprehensive but followed him into what turned out to be his bedroom. He explained that now I would be able to travel instantly between the hallway and his room, which, when he showed me on my map, turned out to be really useful. So, after he had undone the complicated looking lock on the door, we made our way back to the hallway. But before we could even thank him, he was gone again.
Interesting. Alright, so that's chapter 11. It's almost 4 a.m, so I'm gonna go to bed. I have to wake up early tomorrow. By early, I mean like mid-afternoon.
Japan calling. This is Japan calling. Came the voice again from the computer screen. With a big smile, Dr. Hiro explained that they had been contacted by other survivors. But before he could say any more, he was interrupted in the most horrible way. Heather screamed. Nobody knew what to do. "We'll just have to wait," said the old lady, "and pray they're okay." Suddenly, the doorbell rang. Which was odd, as everyone we knew was already here. As it turned out, the old lady had telephoned the shopkeeper and junkyard owner. They offered to help with their wares, and were parked just outside if I needed them.
Hey, maybe I can buy something. What is this? Looking to get buff? Hell yeah.
Help.
Give me the buff.
Would you like that one gift wrapped, sir? That will cost you 20,000.
Hell yeah. Let's get buffed. Hello? I don't know what that does, but okay.
Help. Restocking on shit.
Nope. Hey.
Help. Sir needs to extend his jumping range. The float jump will help with that. That will cost you 60,000.
Okie dokie. Nice.
Sir deserves a little time off, I'm sure. The charge for it is 10,000.
Hell yeah. That's it? Yeah, that's it. Let me just double check though. Yep, that's it.
Now then, said the dirty old man, let's see what you've got. Can't say fairer than that. That's going straight on eBay. It's a bit broken, but I'll take it. Everything else is junk. Go on then, said the younger man, stick everything in Bertha.
Give me the big money, big money. I want big money right now. Big money. Yeah. It's not too big, but it'll have to do. Cool stuff though. All right, I'm gonna like stop here. I need to exit game. Hopefully it keeps my save. It did. Fantastic. All right, we're good. Good to go. How much scrap have I collected? I don't know how to check. Boom, boom, boom. I don't really know what this is. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, that's the next boss. Interesting. Okay. All right. I think I'm gonna end it here. Actually, this seems appropriate, and I'll just go exit this room. I think and be good. So. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. See you on the next time on Dragon Ball Z. Alright, Gabagool.
Gabagool.